Some need the fight in order to keep the faithful interested. One of the big challenges of being a cult leader, it seems, is always having some dramatic thing going on to keep everybody stirred up. Another big reason is that management, and when I use the term management, I mean the Chief Mahuff and his close circle of lieutenants who actually run the group. Management cannot be perceived as being less than invincible or less than invulnerable. And if you bring the big yogi in and sit him down in the deposition room and force him to answer your questions and cross-examine him when he lies to you, and you catch him in lies, the mere fact that he has to respond to your notice, and the mere fact that he has to be there, is evidence that he does not make the world turn. And that's a political problem. I never was able to get Yogi Bhajan into a deposition in a year and a half of litigation. Every time he came up for deposition, he would have one of his followers, who was a medical doctor, write him a medical excuse. And the judge let him get away with that 5 times. So that he couldn't come and testify, because that would be answering to another authority. Not my authority, it would be the authority of the court, but in the group it would be perceived as my authority. And now there's some question about who the Chief Mahuff really is. So they fight you for that reason. The ones who leave under no circumstances can be seen to prevail. One of the things I've learned about at least those groups that I worked with is when you leave, you're defamed. He's going to die now. He's left the protection of the spiritual protection of the guru, so he's going to be reincarnated as a cockroach, or the negative energy is going to get you now that you're out in the world, or the devil will occupy you. I'm just going down the list. You will no longer realize your full potential, and you'll be unhappy the rest of your life. Those are four of the ones I can think of. Well, that kind of all goes to hell if the person covers a big money judgment against the group and walks away with cash. All of a sudden, they are powerful and they have succeeded, and you see them in court and they're no longer ash and gray and they're wearing nice clothes and people are shaking hands and everybody's smiling. Well, management has a real problem with that. The litigation is a serious threat to their internal control. So they fight you for non-economic reasons, and that makes it hard on a lawyer. Throughout all of this, you're going to hear money talked about.
point which I want to discuss with you, it is about rape. I have heard a lot of different versions. And some people have asked me a lot of questions, and I never answered that. Today I want to talk to you about it. First of all, nobody can be raped until you do not invite it. Rape is always invited, it never happens. A person who is raped is always providing subconsciously the environments and the arrangements. If you do not provide the circumstances and the arrangements, it is impossible.